Actually, I hail from a village in Karnataka where there was no ambience for music. So, but my mother wanted, because my grandfather, mother, they were all musicians, she wanted me to be a musician. So she sent, after my SLC, she sent to a village, a town called Shimoga, where I started my learning. Well, I started quite late in music, but I was interested because the family was musically oriented. Then after my graduation and everything, I went to Chennai and I was learning under T. Rukmini, another violin artist. And I was very blessed and fortunate that Lal Guru sir heard me playing and he called me to be his disciple.
That's
so
wonderful.
That was a very turning point in my life, and I did Gurukulavasam with him. Gurukulavasam means you stay with the teacher and be with him. Whenever he has time, he share the music. I will go with him to tours, concerts. So by listening to his playing and by listening his concerts, being with him, I learnt a lot, 5-6 years. Then I started playing concerts and it's how it's.
That's how your journey in music started.
Yeah.
That's really interesting that you were invited by Sri Lal Guruji himself to come and stay with him and learn music.
Yeah.
I've seen that violin, it accompanies the vocalist. A lot in Carnatic style, which doesn't happen as much in Hindustani style. So what is the reason that the violin is one instrument that has been chosen as a part of accompaniment, and not only that, but it has been chosen to be a solo instrument? So please tell us about
actually in
how
olden
violin
days, if you see, because violin is a new entrant to Indian music. Only in British period it came to Indian music, and they say that one of the Trinity composers, Muthuswami Dikshitar's brother, Balaswami Dikshitar, he tried to tune it in a different way to adapt to the Indian music system. So it is all very newly added to the Indian music. But previously Chitra Veena and Veena were the accompanying instrument. But once violin came, that too developed over the years, the violin's capability of bringing the almost equal to the voice, you know, the
human voice.
So that made it as one of the very prominent accompanying instruments. Because even the vocalist wants a violin, even the flute artist wants a violin, even the Chitravina artists have a violin with him, because it almost reflects, brings out the qualities of every other instrument. And it also has its individuality. Mainly our South Indian music is Sahitya oriented, lyrics oriented. So with the help of the bow, we can give the lyrical effect.
Okay.
So So that is how you can able to see the singing of the instrument. You can, if you know the song, if you know the lyrics of the song, the violin, you can hear the song, lyrics on the violin. And my Guruji Lal Guru sir was very famous for that.
Yes.
His violin was almost a singing violin.
Yeah.
That's how it became very popular.
Yeah.
And very close to the voice.
Mm-hmm.
So the accompanying, when you have some difficulty in singing, that is the long breath, long notes, the violin will help by giving you the long things.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Do you think violin surpasses the human voice also? Do you think that happens?
But as an accompanying instrument, it won't be nice to surpass the human voice. Otherwise, violin has great range because human voice has almost 1.5 to 2 octaves.
Yeah.
Or maybe 2.5 octaves for some artists. But violin has a big range.
Oh, so
it may surpass.
It may
and
surpass.
Even the speed, the violin can play the speeder version of the voice.
Oh, okay.
And the violin can also play longer notes which you cannot get in voice.
One of the rag that you sang was Mohanam Kalyani?
Mohana Kalyani, yes.
Mohana Kalyani. Is that your composition that
no,
you
No, it is my Guruji's composition. Lal Guruji Jayaraman sir's composition.
Okay.
It is a Varnam.
It's a Varnam.
Mm. Varnam has a specific style of composition. It's a specific style of composition.
Mm-hmm.
Which has a Pallavi, Anupallavi, and there are some swaras.
Mm-hmm.
Then there is a small lyrical piece called Charanam.
Mm-hmm.
Then again there are 3-4 swaras. It is a pattern which is
which
adopted
is
by
format.
All fixed pattern.
Fixed format.
Yes.
Yeah,
if you see Carnatic music compositions, like Varnam, Santillanas, those compositions, there is very little scope for improvisation. Because whatever the composer composes, we perfect it and we sing it.
Mm-hmm.
And even the gamakas in Lal Guruji sir's compositions, even the gamakas are preset. We can just, because he done it so beautifully,
yeah,
that nobody can make it better than that.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it is. But when it comes to Kirtanam Skritis, as you said, in the Bandish, we have lots of scope for improvisation,
mm-hmm,
not on the rendering of the Kritis. The rendering of the Kritis again goes back to the composer's theme.
Okay.
And he usually he set some sangatis, what the variations,
mm-hmm,
in the Pallavi or Anupallavi and the,
mm-hmm,
the whole pattern. And we almost, of course, the artist will change little bit here and there,
mm-hmm,
because it is a improvisation subject. But mostly it is set.
Okay.
But we have, of course, we have the Raga Alapana before that. I can sing Mohana Kalyani Ragam before this Varnam, which is completely of my own imagination.
Okay.
And after, I can take a small piece, maybe that Charanam part, and I can keep on singing it in various places like that. We call it as Niravar.
Okay.
That is also there. That's another type of improvisation we can do.
Mm-hmm.
And we do the solfas, the swara prastaras.
Mm-hmm.
That is, we Patapi Ganapati, we do all the swaras there.
Mm-hmm.
So that is also possible. It is a solfa style of singing, improvising.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a lot of improvisation places, but not on the, when it comes to the Kriti,
mm-hmm,
we sing it, we perform it as if the composer has composed it.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's how you are able to maintain the pure nature of that composition.
Yes, yes.
And also the great composers,
yes,
who have,
because the composers are not
that,
only,
right,
composing the lyrics, they are also composing the music. They are called Vagyakaras.
Mm-hmm.
The lyricist is different than the Vagyakara. Vagyakara is the one who sets music also.
Okay.
The lyrics and the music is set by the composer, so we have to be adopting the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if you sing a bhajan in our Carnatic style or something else, we can change it. We can change the tune. We will. You can sing it in Vitala Salava Swami. Today I sang in Desh.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I can sing in any other raga.
Okay.
So it is possible because Purandar Das is a composer who just composed.
Mm-hmm.
And he also sang it in different ragas, but it was in 13th century.
Yes.
So you don't know in which raga he has sung.
Mm-hmm.
So people heard that, and the families who passed it to the next generation.
Mm-hmm.
We have some ragas which have been composed by Purandar Das, but most of the things we have changed it now.
Oh, okay.
So that's how it is.
Okay.
But these Kritis are, they are all Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshitar and Shama,
mm-hmm,
Shastris.
Mm-hmm.
They are all composed in a pattern, and we are
yeah,
going to be,
yeah,
performing it in the same way.
That's very interesting to know.
Yeah.
And
so
I,
when it comes to this Jugalbandi, or so,
mm-hmm,
we, instead of taking a Kriti, we take a small lyrical piece like a Pallavi,
mm-hmm,
and the Hindustani artist can improvise. Even a jazz artist can improvise the beat, and the Carnatic artist can improvise it with the lyrics and all this. It is possible when it is a small composition, mm-hmm. which may be the composition of the artist himself who is performing. But when it comes to the Kriti, they will just adopt the same pattern when they perform.
What is your message for the upcoming generation who are interested in music? How should they pursue it, and you know, any message that they can carry along that is coming from
you? Actually, in recent days, I have seen the younger generation loving so much about this art. Mm-hmm. Of course, the first initiation is only with the parents. Mm-hmm. They will make them sit in the class, bring them to the class and all those. But after that, because it in our days, it was not a fashion to learn Carnatic music.
Mm-hmm.
But now, learning some art form, maybe Bharatanatyam or music or maybe tabla or whatever, became a fashion. Oh, I am learning. So there are so many people who also come and learn. So that's how they, I think, get motivated into learning that art.
Mm-hmm.
And there is ample number of opportunities. There are competitions, there are stage performances. A small child who performs at the beginning level will be given a stage and encouraged nowadays.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, in the olden days, only the masters will get the chance to perform. Today, everybody will perform. So they get some reward in return.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why they want to learn. And I have seen lots of musicians who learn Western classical violin.
Mm-hmm.
Once they start learning Carnatic violin and start performing in the small temples for this small aradhanas and other things,
mm-hmm.
then they don't go back to Western, because they know that there you are one in 100, but here you are one in one. So that's how it motivates them more.
Mm-hmm.
And first, usually I say the parents that it's the greatest gift they can give to the children,
mm-hmm.
because sending to music classes may, even though he may not become a musician, but it will definitely change their personality and the way of outlook, the way they see the things outside, maybe over the years. So the greatest gift the parent can give the child is music or some art form. And once they come and in this surrounding, see here, if you can see all the students, they were lovingly participating in the music class. So this is very rare to see now. But nowadays, everywhere, not in the previous days I am saying, nowadays it is possible. Because they are having lots of opportunities, their peers are learning,
mm-hmm.
and so they are motivated.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is continuing in a very grand way. So there is actually, there is, I don't have to say anything in that aspect, because it's going flourishing very well.
So you are seeing some good,
wonderful.
Anywhere
I do
things
the,
coming in
coming,
future.
Yes. Anywhere I do the workshops and all the youngsters come and they give full 100%
mm-hmm.
of their focus, the music.
Mm-hmm. So I'm really grateful to you. Thank you so much
for sharing
your suggestions, and we look forward to see you.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.